Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be taking a quick look at Leonardo AI. It's a new Midjourney competitor and one that stacks up really well. It's better than Adobe Firefly and some of the other options around, and quite similar to Midjourney in a lot of ways, but it has a better user interface. So we're going to have a look at that. So let's jump straight into it. This is it just here. So at the moment, it's still in sort of an early access thing. So if you want to use it, just head on over to the website. I'll leave a link in the description. Just whack your email in, click count me in, and you'll be added to the list. It took me a few weeks to get in, so don't expect anything straight away, but just keep an eye out in your email for access. Once you do have access, you can just simply click the link in your email, sign up, and you'll be given access just like this. So some of the stuff coming out of it's really good. I would say it's probably second to Midjourney, though some of the results are pretty much on par. So using it is pretty straightforward. It's a lot more user-friendly than Midjourney. So you'll get 150 tokens a day, which you consume when you generate content. Now, how much each generation uses depends on some of the settings, but we'll go through that in a second. Along the top here, we have different art styles. So you can select any one of these styles to get this sort of image style when you generate content. So it's a little bit of a pre-start option. So selecting one of these styles will generally get you something within that ballpark. So we'll just have a quick look at the options here. There's quite a few and quite a few popular styles you've probably seen coming out of Midjourney and the other places already. So some of the unique ones I've found here are the pixel art, the isometric fantasy, and some of the sci-fi building ones here. So these are quite cool and give some pretty good results. So let's just try one of the RPG 4.0 styles to begin with. So we'll click generate with this model. Over here, we will go to our prompting screen. So this here is a result I tried earlier. Okay, so we're going to try this prompt. It's probably a little bit extreme, but we'll see what we get. So we're using RPG 4.0. Now here we have an option to add Leonardo style. This is sort of a styling specific to the Leonardo AI. It's hard to explain exactly what this does, but if you want to try it, just select it. Next we have the add negative prompt. So just enable this, and here you can add anything that you don't want in your image. So you can say something like don't use the color blue, or you can just write blue, hats, birds, whatever. Obviously, I'll say that again with using commas to separate. So that's basically what you're going to do for a negative prompt. So we're going to disable a negative prompt and see what it does by itself. Most importantly here, we have how many tokens this is going to use. So we're going to use 4 tokens, 146 left. However, over on the side here, we have some more options that will affect our token usage. So we have image dimensions. And each time we adjust these, we are going to change the amount of tokens we use. So if we generate 1024 by 1024, we're going to use 7 tokens. So while you're experimenting, keep to the smallest option to use the least amount of tokens. Otherwise, you can use the manual slider here to adjust. You've also got your aspect ratio. Generally, we will stick with the 1:1 for this image. Guidance scale, pretty straightforward. This is best set on 7, but you can adjust the creativity of the AI by sliding it either lower or higher. 7 seems to work the best, so I wouldn't be messing around with that too much unless you really want to start throwing in some variables. Just going to disable dark mode here for a second so we can actually see these things properly. So basically there we go, how strongly the prompt is weighted. There is your input for an image. So if you want to add an image, just add one in and prompt from that. So we're going to try what we've got now and generate something. So we're going to go the standard 4 images, smallest size, no negative prompt, using 4 tokens. So let's generate and see what happens. Okay, so that's our result. Nothing really special. Kind of similar to the stuff I've seen coming out of Adobe Firefly and basic Midjourney stuff. So we'll try a couple of different ones and some different prompts. So let's try isometric fantasy, generate with this model. Tiny forest world, the Witcher universe. See what happens. Set it to the smallest size again, just to be conservative with the tokens. You only get 150 a day, so try to use them sparingly if you're trying to make content and you don't want to pay. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Definitely got a bit of a witchery style to it. Okay, so we'll do one more. Let's go over to pixel art. Let's try manted fantasy character. Interesting. More of a druid style, but it'll do. Below here, there's also trending creations, so some of these are pretty good. You can see, we'll click on this one here. Gives you full information on the prompt details, negative prompt, resolution, etc. So this option here will allow you to go straight to generating from this prompt and this information. The only thing you need to take into consideration is this part down here. So that's the feature model Dream Shaper V5. So we're going to do one generate off this image. So image to image. So here we're still using pixel art. So in order to get this to work the same as before, we need to go back over, select custom model, platform models, and we need to choose the same one. So Dream Shaper version 5. That's the one they were using. Generate with this model. Done. So now we can click generate. Let's go four images, generate, and see how close to that original prompt it will get. Okay, so the last thing I'll mention here is some of the upscaling options, etc. So once you've got your images, so we've got these ones just here, you've got a list of options. So just hover over each and it'll tell you exactly what it does. Some of the upscaling options here are pretty good. So just go through these, check what you want. Just remember that each one's going to use tokens, so try to use this sparingly. And as always, you've got your option to download. Anyway, that wraps up this guide on Leonardo AI. I hope you found it useful and not too complicated, but compared to other ones like Midjourney, Stable Diffusion, Leonardo AI is looking pretty good already. It's definitely better than Adobe Firefly. If you haven't checked out Adobe Firefly, I'll leave some links in the description to check that one out. It's pretty good, but definitely has a lot of work to go. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on another video. Cheers, everyone.